And Peter, back for his third consecutive night.
Yes, will Peter pick a perfect prize or...
I'll stop you there.
Good, I'd run out
Settle
of
in Australia. The game is on. Welcome to Temptation. Tuesday, and our champ is back, and you've brought your posse along to cheer tonight as well, Peter.
Yes.
You've stacked the audience with family members.
Oh, couldn't hurt.
Now, you've got your beautiful daughter, Chelsea, here, along with your mum and dad too, which is nice. Chelsea, how's Dad going so far?
Good. Yeah.
Does he play along at home?
Yes.
Is he pretty smart at home?
Sometimes.
And sometimes Dad's not so smart.
Yeah.
All right then. Well, fingers crossed for your dad, mum and dad, watching Peter go. Good luck to you, champ. A couple of new challengers waiting in the wings to go tonight. Who
They're
are they?
They're standing by. Our first challenger loves experimenting in the kitchen, creating all sorts of Asian dishes. From Hawthorne East Victoria, break out the chopsticks and chow down with Anne Ricker.
Hello, Anne.
Hi, Ed.
Our second challenger wants to own his own hot air balloon and float above Australia's most scenic places. Will Temptation leave him on cloud nine? From Mount Kohler, New South Wales, welcome Gilbert Vanderjagt.
Hello, Gilbert.
Sorry, I stumbled over your name.
And you teach both history and geography?
Yes, very
handy. We had a couple of teachers on who seemed to go pretty well, in fact, on the show.
Hope so.
Although there's the pressure that all your students are watching at home and that their teacher makes a fool of himself.
No, won't happen.
Don't add more pressure to the poor man.
Good luck to you. Welcome on to the show.
Now, Anne, I need to quiz you about some cooking tips because everything I burn, I decide to call Cajun. So I made Cajun brownies last week.
Lovely.
I don't think you can have Cajun brownies, can you?
I think you can create anything, can't you?
We love it when Lavinia invites us all over for dinner because we always leave with a very sore stomach from that Cajun cooking.
What's your favourite recipe that you whip up?
Oh, it'd be a toss-up between Thai and Indian one, something within there. No one particular one, just keep experimenting and trying it all out.
Delicious. If she invites you over, though, just be busy.
Hey, that's enough. $20 starting money for you all, and you, cheeky, I shall leave you now.
I'll pass on the cookies. Thanks. Here we go, everybody. Good luck. According to the second line of the poem, The Man from Snowy River, the colt from old Watt had got away. Anne.
Regret.
And you are away as well. Which former GP was elected to federal parliament in... Gilbert.
Brendan Nelson.
No, as a Tasmanian Greens senator, Bob Brown we needed there. In the Bible's book of Revelation, white, red, black and pale are the horses ridden... Peter.
Four horses of apocalypse.
You are right. The champ's away as well. Let's get into a gallop ourselves. Two, it's our first sprint round. 20 seconds up on the clock. Good luck. Your time starts now. Pureed or mashed avocado seasoned with condiments makes... Anne.
Guacamole.
Yes. Cameron Diaz, Drew Barrymore and Lucy Liu play Sinema's Peter.
Charlie's Angels.
Yes. What is the upper house called in the Australian Federal... Gilbert.
Senate.
Yes. Singing the hit song Working Class Man was Aussie... Peter.
Jimmy Barnes.
Yes. The Pilbara is a region in which Australian... Anne.
Western Australia.
Yes. Dividing a ship into compartments is the petition called a bulk what? Peter.
Head.
Jumping in on the base of the champ is right. Yes. Good work. Gets you just into the lead too. Very timely opportunity for you to get some free money here. It's the Temptation Vault, Peter. You played last night. If you buzz in, you'll have the chance to score somewhere between $1 and $5,000 cash. Just buzz in if you want to do it again. All right. The vault is open for business. Hit your buzzer once more and that cash will be yours. $3,565. What did you get last night? Over $4,000 worth. So pocketing some good cash there earlier, champ. Which wandering and warlike people had invaded the Roman Empire in the AD... Gilbert.
The Huns?
It was the Huns, led by Attila. In which Japanese dish are vegetables or seafood dipped in batter? And
tempura.
Oh, you're good with the cooking questions, aren't you? Into the lead. First of our fame game questions as well, $10 behind one of our famous faces. Who am I? Born with the given name Michelle in southern France in 1503 and dying in 1566, I began my medical practice in 1529 and moved to the town of Ceylon, where I became known for my innovative medicine and treatment during outbreaks of the plague in 1546 and 47. Appointed physician in ordinary by Charles IX when he became king, my fame rests on a book published in 1555 that was enlarged for a second edition. It consisted of rhymed quatrains grouped... Gilbert.
Nostradamus.
Was Nostradamus, you are right. And if you have some of the talents of Nostradamus, you'll know where the money is lying. Let's see the famous faces tonight with Lavinia.
Keeping us up well past our bedtime, David Letterman, The Late Show, Kelly Connolly, A Current Affair. On our screens tonight, Charlie Sheen, Two and a Half Men. One of the high fivers, Charlie Robinson. Moby, who's touring Australia at the moment. He's got a new album, Hotel, out. Melina Kanakaridis, CSI New York. David Hyde Pierce, Frasier. Spend Your Mornings with Kerri-Anne Kennelly. And Chris Smith, National 9 News in Sydney.
What a choice of talented people you have before you, Gilbert. Who will it be?
Well, I liked Frasier, so David Hyde Pierce.
Great show. The fabulous Niles. Good luck.
Show you mean business with this casual luggage collection. The three bags priced at $580 from Packlight.
Nice little pickup, Gilbert. And we have got everybody off and firing so far tonight. I've got a feeling it's going to be one of those good games. Stay with us for round two. It's right after this. Round two, players. Who wrote the 1982 biography of the Australian politician whom she later married, Bob Hawke? Gilbert.
Blanche Delpuget.
Delpuget, that'll do. It's nice French. The name of which Broadway musical is also a regular payment made by a tenant? Anne.
Rent.
Is Rent, yes. Which member of the British royal family recently graduated with a Master of Arts? Peter.
William.
It was Prince William from St Andrews University. Everybody getting a shot at the questions. Anne, the bell has tolled for you, though. You lead on $45. You're 10 clear of Peter. I wonder if we can tempt you with this fashionable item, Lavinia.
Every woman deserves to own a piece, or two, or three, or more, of Alana Hill. Opulent fabrics, floating feminine frocks and delicate accessories sparkle and shimmer, tempting you to wear them. Tonight's collection is $1,800 worth of designer clothing. For a tempting $10, how can you resist Alana Hill?
Mm-hmm. Hello, Nick. I get the feeling this is going to be quite an easy sell for us.
Oh, I wouldn't get that impression.
Really, you wouldn't?
Oh,
okay. So you're just not interested. Shall I just walk away?
I didn't say that.
Were you saying maybe you'd like it going once?
It
to go twice?
You're waiting for Ed to drop the price.
Yeah, but you lead by 10. $8 going once, twice. It's really sold. There we go. Good work. Well bought. And the questions continue. Having almost one-tenth of the world's known oil reserves, is which country that was invaded by Iraq in... Gilbert.
Kuwait.
Is right as well, up to $35. Very tight game. When he visited West Berlin in June 1963, which world leader famously said, "Ich..." Bill Gilbert.
John F. Kennedy.
JFK said, "I am a Berliner." Fame game time, the $15 now in play behind one of our famous faces. Who am I? Born in Massachusetts in 1920 and dying in Beverly Hills in 1996, I dropped out of both the College of the Holy Cross and West Point Military Academy, but by 1950 had earned a BA, a Master's and a PhD, the latter from the University of California at Berkeley, where I subsequently taught. Directing psychological research at the Kaiser Foundation Hospital in Oakland, from 1959 I lectured at Harvard, where I began experimenting with mild mind-altering drugs. Dismissed from Harvard in 1963, a colleague and I took over a mansion in Millbrook in New York State, and I continued to promote social rebellion, famously urging people to turn on, tune in, drop out. My first name is Timothy, and with us, Peter.
Leary?
Dr. Timothy Leary gets the champ, a look at our famous faces. That's right. LSD guru he was. All right, Peter, it's your pick. Who will it be?
The kids always loved them growing up, so I'll take Charlie from High Five.
Good luck with Charlie from High Five.
Peter, these two pairs of stainless steel sunglasses will protect your peepers. They're $726 from Maui Jim Sunglasses.
Chelsea likes the look of those. Dad could look cool. And round two rolls on. Of concern to grammar purists, the phrase to boldly go is an example of splitting the what? Peter.
Infinitive.
Yes, never do it, kids. Share of the lead for you. Incorporating the world's first heat-sealed, air-cushioned sole was which boot named after its inventor, a German Anne?
Doc Martin.
Doc Martens. We need an S on the S. Sorry about that. Seven of the top 10 on Rolling Stone magazine's list of the best albums of all time are from which decade of the last century? Peter.
60s.
The 60s, yes. New leader we have, and a sprint round up on the cards, 20 seconds worth. Here we go. Your time starts now. How many points is an inner bullseye worth in darts? Peter.
50.
Yes. Difficulty in experiencing a new situation is called a baptism of what? Peter.
Fire.
Yes. Who plays Bad Santa in the 2003 film, Anne?
Billy Bob Thornton.
Yes. In which sea is the island nation of Barbados? Gilbert.
Caribbean.
Yes. For what does the P stand in the abbreviation RSPCA, Anne?
Prevention.
Yes. On the buzzer. Good work. Very tight game still here at Temptation. Peter, good work. Up to $55. You're clear, but only by a couple of questions from both Anne and Gilbert. We can take a short breather. Round three awaits us. It's on the other side of this break. We'll see you.
Lavinia.
It is time to live the dream. Red carpet, velvet robe, flashing cameras, part of life for the owner of this men's watch. The classic stainless steel timepiece features a Swiss self-winding mechanism and sapphire scratch-resistant glass. It's $4,995, or be tempted to impress for $15 from Raymond Weil.
Oh, that's really nice, isn't it?
Great.
$10
clear. Are you a watchman?
Oh, it's a bit close.
It is. It's only $10. That's quite close. That's just two questions, Peter, really, when you think about it. So you've got a decision to make. Can we tempt you? We want 15 from you. Beautiful watch.
You'll get it back on the Fame Game board.
Okay.
Hard sell from Lavinia. Well bought, Gilbert, our new leader. It's round three rolls on. Unhappily married to a small town doctor is the heroine of Gustave Flaubert's 1857 novel, Madame Who? Gilbert.
Bovary.
Bovary, yes. Sees you extend your lead. What name is shared by the largest city in the US state of Alabama and the second largest city in the UK? Anne.
Birmingham.
Birmingham is right, up to 47. In which decade of last century did Valéry Giscard d'Estaing become president of France? Gilbert.
The 70s.
In the 1970s, yes. Good game. And now, very important final pick of the Fame Game. $25 also in play along with the wild card, so who am I? Born in Western Australia in 1925 and dying in 2004, I developed an interest in my sport while attending Northam High School. While at the University of WA, I won the state and Australian sprint and hurdles titles and earned a physics degree in 1946. With bronze in the 80 metres hurdles and the 100 metres in 1948, along with the silver in the 4x100 relay, I became the first Australian woman to win athletics medals at the Olympics. Marrying a geologist in 1950, at Helsinki in the 1952 Games, I won bronze in the 100 metres and gold in the 80 metre hurdles, becoming the first woman athlete to retain an...
Betty Cuthbert?
Not Betty Cuthbert. The first woman athlete to retain an Olympic title. Winning a total of 7 Olympic medals, my first name is Shirley. Peter.
Strickland.
Well-timed champ. Yes, Shirley Strickland or Della Hunty. You trail by 15, Peter. A timely pick here. We'll see you into the lead. Who will it be? I like his gravelly voice, so Charlie Sheen.
Charlie Sheen from 2.5 Men. Good luck.
$15, Peter.
Whoa. Very timely pick from you, Peter. The rest of the money in play too. Lavinia, where was it tonight?
The wild card was with David Letterman. Moby had the $10 and the big money behind Kelly Connolly.
Lavinia said you'd pick up all that cash, Peter. She was right. That pays off the watch, and we have a tied game, $60 apiece between Peter and Gilbert, and just a couple of questions in arrears, and it's all set for a final showdown. The final round away. 60 seconds fast money, everybody. This will sort out our champ for Tuesday night. Good luck. Your time starts now. Indicating time after Christ, AD stands for Anno. Peter.
Domini.
Yes. What's the first name of Russian tennis star Sharapova? Anne.
Maria.
Yes. A recent hit single for Green Day is Boulevard of What? Gilbert.
Broken Dreams.
Yes. Proverbially, necessity is the mother of what? Gilbert.
Invention.
Yes. By what first name do we know French impressionist painter Degas? Edgar. Skippers, butterflies and what make up the order Lepidoptera? Peter.
Butterflies.
Moths. What is the sequel to the film Ocean's 11? Peter.
Ocean's 12.
Yes. President of the ACTU is Sharon who? Peter.
Burrows.
Burrow. Having a mildly nutty, sweet flavour, what type of food is Gruyere? Peter.
Cheese.
Yes. In the US Virgin Islands, singer Kenny Chesney married actor Renee who? Anne.
Zellweger.
Yes. Starting with S, is which atmospheric layer above the troposphere? Peter.
Stratosphere.
Yes. Who is Sir Richard Attenborough's famous naturalist brother? Gilbert.
David Attenborough.
Yes. Starting with C and ending in A, is what punctuation mark? Peter.
Comma.
Yes. In demography, ZPG stands for zero what? Out of time there. We have a tied game. We needed zero population growth to sort out a champ. However, it'll come down to a Fame Game question. Anne, you're out of this. Gilbert and Peter. An incorrect answer will cost you the game. We need a correct answer for a win. So, for the match, who am I? Born in Hartford, Connecticut in 1907 and dying in 2003, I graduated from Bryn Mawr College in Pennsylvania in 1928 and made my stage debut the same year. In 1932, I made my film debut and won an Oscar for only my third film, Morning Glory. A Broadway flop and a series of unsuccessful films threatened to derail my career, but I returned to Broadway in The Philadelphia Story, and my career was back on track after I starred in the film version in 1940.
I went on to win a record 4 Oscars and starred in such films as The African Queen and Guess Who's Coming to Dinner? With a first name Catherine. Peter?
Hepburn.
Champ, you win!
Whoa, on the buzzer. Catherine Hepburn gets you over the line.
Very exciting.
Wowee. Just about all the clues going out. No one really wanted to jump in and cost themselves the game.
Wow.
Peter, cool in a crisis, well done. We feel the same way, believe us. Well done.
Gilbert, you put up an amazing fight. Congratulations. Yeah. You've got the luggage worth $580. Thank you very much.
It's as close as it gets. Well played.
And Anne, for someone who came on Temptation as a dare, you've done very well. You've got the $1,800 worth of Alana Hill clothes.
Thank
Enjoy.
You.
You've won that game. Hopefully had some fun too. Great game by both our challengers. Well done. We've also got this terrific consolation prize for both of you.
We have a shiny temptation to take with you tonight. This 10 gram bar of precious gold is guaranteed 99.99% pure gold. It's from the Perth Mint.
Oh, Peter, how cool are you under pressure? Oh. I think a golf game can only improve if you're this cool,
it
you know,
must.
With the questions firing, standing over those long putts, you could make them.
Mm.
Still no hole in one. However, you went for the kitchen package from Smeg. You put it all on the line and it's now yours.
Give the heart in your home a complete modern makeover with the latest in European kitchen appliances from Smeg. There's a stainless steel dishwasher, electric oven with gas cooktop and range hood, an impressive fridge-freezer combination, a 34-litre microwave oven, we'll even throw in a kitchen sink. This functional and stylish collection is a $20,815 temptation from Smeg.
Wow, that's yours if you want it. No more frightening sight, though, than Lavinia about to start cooking stuff in the kitchen, as we've already established. That's yours. Great package. However, play on and win tomorrow night. A $38,000 holiday awaits you. Could be off to New York. Let's take a look.
Experience the bright lights of New York City on this amazing holiday for two. Staying 5 nights at the W, taking the Empire State Building, a baseball game, or just shop till you drop. Then shop some more in Bangkok with $2,000 spending money and 2 nights at the Sheraton Grand Sukhumvit. Plus, you'll fly first class to Bangkok and business to New York. What a luxury. Tempted? Take a bite from the Big Apple at $38,479 from Thai Airways International, W Hotels and Sheraton Hotels.
Peter, I'm hearing a lot about shopping on this holiday. There's some holiday, but it's all about shopping, isn't it?
It's always about the shopping, Ed.
Alrighty, Nicole's bought me something too, which is very nice. Now, another win for you, champ. We'll see you driving away in your very own brand new Volvo. Here it is.
Let the adventure begin with the brand new XC70 SE. This all-wheel drive wagon with a powerful turbo engine caters equally well for the rough stuff and the need for intelligent luxury. Renowned safety features, versatile flexibility and a luxury leather interior complete with child booster cushions make it perfect for the active family. Priced at $56,950 plus on-road costs. Sometimes freedom is closer than you think. Volvo, for life.
A fine vehicle could be yours for 5 nights. The equation's simple too, Peter. 6 nights, everything will be yours. 7 nights, this.
Yes, Peter, you're 1 night closer to the ultimate temptation. $500,000 in solid gold.
It's a big lure, isn't it, Peter? All right, simple decision. Do you want to take that fabulous kitchen package worth over $20,000 or come back and win tomorrow? Be off to New York, $38,000 plus worth. Got your mum and dad in the audience there, along with your lovely daughter, Chelsea. Here's 10 seconds to have a think about what you want to do. Is anybody in the crowd helping you out? Mum, dad, what'll it be?
Master of my own domain, I'll come back.
Good for you. The champ's coming back for another night, which means we get to add maybe some more cash into your cash account. So you've decided to pass on that beautiful kitchen package. Your level 4 prize for winning 4 nights is this trip to New York. Already got $4,000 in that cash account, so let's start to boost that up now. Once again, by playing 10 in a row. Peter, you know how it works, but we'll whip you through the rules once more. You'll have 60 seconds to correctly answer as many questions in a row as you can. For each correct answer you give me, the amount in that cash account will increase. Answer 10 in a row, that amount will hit $100,000. That's the big time. But get one wrong along the way, we're reset back to zero and start again. Same if you pass, we'll take that as an incorrect answer, so you may as well have a guess. 5 different sets of questions await you. Which will it be between 1 and 5?
Stick with number 4.
Stick with number 4? Okay, let's do better than the $2,000 we got last night. Wish you the best of luck. 60 seconds on the clock. Your time starts now. What colour are typical Granny Smith apples?
Green.
Yes.
The full moon on or after March 21 heralds which Christian festival?
Easter.
Yes. What was the first name of German car maker Benz?
Bruce.
Carl. For what does the first A stand in NASA?
Aeronautical.
Aeronautics. What O word specifically denotes a light opera?
Operetta.
Yes. Which royal is president of the British Olympic Association?
Princess Anne.
Yes. In golf, which avian term denotes three below par for a hole?
Albatross.
Yes. Playing the Cooler King in the movie The Great Escape was Steve who?
McQueen.
Yes. Which Australian marsupial starts with B and ends with T? Bandicoot. 13 popes have shared what name of three letters?
Ian.
Leo. A place where horses are kept for breeding is what anagram of dust?
Stud.
Yes. Starting with P is what psychotic disorder commonly involving delusions of persecution?
Paranoia.
Yes. Rhyming with Cinder, out of time there. So, up to $2,000. Got up to $6,000, so that's all right. So you're consistent.
Yes.
Adding to the $2,000 from Monday and the $2,000 from Friday. And your lovely daughter, Chelsea, is here. Wasn't Dad good, Chelsea?
Yeah.
So, $6,000 in your cash account, returning tomorrow night, could be a $100,000 night.
Do it for Chelsea, Peter.
More importantly, playing for that fantastic holiday to New York, which you may get to go on if you're very nice to Dad. Be nice to him overnight. We better get out of here. We'll see you same time tomorrow night, and we'll tempt you again.
Have a great night. Bye-bye.